Magler, don't do 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 do. Magler, don't do 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 do. Magler, don't do 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 do. Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of the Jamie Hughes Show. My name, as always, is Jamie Hughes, and today I'm going to be giving you my review of The Meg. And if you want to keep up to date with all the latest movie news and reviews, then make sure you hit that subscribe button. And as always, my videos, this review may include spoilers, so you have now been warned. So The Meg was, it was fine. I enjoyed it. I kind of wanted to see more from it, if I'm being totally honest. I felt like they were holding some stuff back, but I still enjoyed it. It was a fine movie, but I think the best thing about this movie by far is Jason Statham and his performance. Now, this may sound a bit condescending, but I felt like he was half-arsing it, but really hamming it up at the same time in this movie, and it just worked so well. This is what I wanted the movie to be, was this kind of really kind of a little bit cheesy, but still kind of serious movie, and Jason Statham nailed that. I thought his performance was great. It was kind of nice to see a more comedic side to his acting chops, because we don't really get to see that very often. He was really fun, and as I say, it's just Jason Statham being a lad. Like, what more can I say? He was great. He was just, it was just so ridiculous, but worked so well for me, Jason Statham in this movie. The only thing I'm a little bit disappointed about is that we didn't get to see him have a full-on fist fight with the Megalodon. I would have loved to have seen him knocking 7 bells out of it, but I think the ending we got was still pretty satisfying with him stabbing the shark through the eye. Another thing that I really enjoyed about this movie, and as I say, I wish the movie was more like this kind of segment of the movie, was kind of the film's like climax to the middle act, where they go down into the shark cage and they capture the first Megalodon. That whole sequence, that whole 20 minutes, half an hour, was brilliant, and I really wish the movie had been more like that, because it encapsulated everything that was good about the movie. It had those cheesy moments, it had really some genuinely funny comedic moments, it had great moments of action, but most of all, it had some great moments of suspense. I really loved when the character was going down into the shark cage and we got like a first person view and she was like looking around the cage and we could only see what she could see. I thought that was really great, and it was a really great way of building up genuine suspense in this movie, and I seriously cannot recommend like that whole sequence enough. But as I've kind of just already alluded to in this movie, I really wish they'd have gone a little bit more all out with this film, because, yeah, like I said, Jason Statham was great, and there was another few decent performances in it as well, but what I felt with this movie is that it was very jarring, and it left me feeling almost ambivalent in points. Like, I didn't really care for what was going on. Like I said, I just wanted to see Jason Statham and the gang fighting a giant shark, and I felt like, I hate to say it, but I felt like this movie was just a little bit too story-driven and had too much of a plot going on. Like, I didn't really want that from this film. I wanted it to be big, over-the-top, goofy action. So it's kind of sad to say that, like, something that should be a positive was a negative for me, is that, like, it just felt a little bit too story-driven. It felt like they were trying to do too much with this film. And if you'll pardon the really bad pun, it did feel like they were going a little bit too deep with this movie as well, and it just did feel a little bit jarring points. One of the points for me that really jumped out was Rainn Wilson's character, who had been kind of a comedic sidekick for most of this movie, and then all of a sudden his character just really shifts, and it was like, oh, well, we need to kill him off now, we need to give a reason to kill him off, so we'll kind of turn him half bad just for 10 minutes so he can get like a funny death, even though it didn't really work. It just didn't work for me, and there were moments like that as well a little bit later on in the film. I thought the execution of the Japanese billionaire's death worked really well, actually. It did kind of have an emotional punch, so that worked, but again, it was just, there was a little bit too much of a story going on here, and not as much as like the fun action that I wanted, which was a shame to see. But that being said, like, I still enjoyed The Meg. It's really hard, but I don't want to be negative about this film, because it was enjoyable for like a 2-hour movie summer blockbuster. It was fine. I just wanted it to be a bit more big dumb fun. I wanted it to be more like films that we've seen earlier on this year, you know, like Rampage and stuff. I just wanted it to be a little bit more self-aware and kind of That was it. I think that's my point I'm trying to make there, is that I wish it was just a little bit more self-aware. It was a little bit more in on the jokes it was making. Like, it knew, like, yeah, we're making a film about Jason Statham fighting a giant shark, like, wink, wink, nudge, nudge. It was trying to be fun, but trying to be serious at the same time with that additional story that it was trying to drive, whereas if they'd have just taken a step back and just gone, yeah, let's make this as goofy as possible, it would have worked really well. So it's just a little bit of a shame, but as I say, it's still an enjoyable movie. For a big, fun summer blockbuster, it works fine. It's just, I would have liked to have seen it be a little bit more big and a little bit more fun and a little bit more over the top. But it's not to say that's not enjoyable. But if you guys have seen The Meg, let me know what you thought about it, as always, down in those comments below. And if you did enjoy this video and you want to keep up to date with all the latest movie news and reviews, then make sure you hit that subscribe button. And as always, I will see you in the very next episode of The Jamie Hughes Show. Ta-ra!